Now you can create optimized integration parameters for your chromatograms to get the best results the first time with the Integration Optimizer in OpenLab CDS 2.6. In this video, I'll show you how to use it to quickly develop processing method settings based on your own data. The first step is to open data analysis and load data that contains chromatograms that you want to integrate. For the best result, this should be a dataset that contains your compounds of interest in both sample injections and standard injections across your calibration range. In this example, I'll use a hydrocarbon mix. Once your data is loaded, click in the ribbon to select the Integration Optimizer layout. This will adjust the display to show the Integration Optimizer wizard and your currently selected chromatogram. If your data contains multiple signal channels, you'll be developing parameters for the currently selected signal. Start by choosing your preferred integrator, ChemStation or EasyChrome. Now we'll adjust the integration range by dragging the edges of the dotted red box in the chromatogram window. Select a range that excludes solvent peaks, as well as noise beyond the last peak of interest. Next, adjust the green smallest peak range box in the chromatogram window. Zoom in if needed, and frame in your smallest peak of interest by dragging the edges of the box into place. Click Next to proceed to the next step in the wizard. Now, in the integration and tuning section of the wizard, we'll fine-tune some key parameters. The wizard sets slider values in a range that's appropriate for your current dataset, to make it easy. And to speed things along, baselines and other annotations in the chromatogram are updated in real time as you drag the sliders to adjust the values. I like to start with data from a standard injection to do the initial tuning pass. First, adjust the peak width until you're satisfied with the baselines. Then, adjust slope sensitivity to check that peak separations meet your needs. Then, adjust the height reject slider to eliminate small peaks that you want to exclude. Now let's zoom into one of our poorly separated peaks and select a new peak separation mode. You can select from Valley Dropline, Baseline at Valley, Exponential Skim, and Linear Skim. I'll use an exponential skim. And then adjust the skim ratio slider until the skimming applies to my peaks as intended. Now that we have the initial parameters for processing a standard injection, I'll select data from a sample injection to see how well these apply. I'll make some updates to the slider values to make sure I'm happy with the sample processing. You can add annotations from the chromatogram window toolbar to help with visualizing your result. You can show and hide tick marks for your baseline boundaries right here, or add peak result information here. Click Next to proceed to the final step in the wizard. The table of integration events that you created with the wizard settings is shown in the Finalize Parameters section of the wizard. Review the settings and click Update Method to apply these parameters to your currently open processing method. This will also save the method. Now, link it to any dataset and reprocess the data using the updated method to generate new results. I hope you enjoyed this brief tutorial on using the Integration Optimizer. For more videos, visit us at agilent.com.